Look at the water, Ryder. Zoom in on that. This is crazy. This is insane. I think this is maybe the most wind I've played in a long time. I actually hit that with probably a straight ball flight, and I think it moved about 35 yards. Oh! Oh! Wait! Did that go in? Back with another Break 65 episode out here today at Gentle Creek. I've preset a game plan since I actually know this course very well. Today, the goal is just to execute the game plan and hopefully end up in those red numbers in the 60s. So, first hole, we're starting on hole number one, dogleg right, par four. It's into the wind, so most likely gonna hit driver here. Sit. Sit. All right, that's all right. This course is so dependent on wind direction, in my opinion. You just kind of aim pretty far left. If it fades, it fades. If it goes straight, it's all right. Playing with Kevin today. For those of you that don't know Kevin, he created our putters. If I putt well, it's thanks to Kevin. If I putt bad, I'm also blaming Kevin. 111, easy 54, trying to aim at Kevin's ball out there on the green. Just cut it back in there, if anything. Just under full with this shot. You know, I said this in my game plan, but the key today is making your 10 to 15 to 20 footers. That's how you shoot in the 60s. And that's how you break 65. You gotta make a lot of them. We gotta get this exclusive from Kevin here. Look at that, that is a great. Do you design that specifically, or did they come up with
it? The girls did, yeah. We put it on a template.
I would wanna use one of those today, but at the same time, I gotta go with what I know as of now. Old trusty, talked about this in past video, but this is the very first good prototype ever made. A little left to right on this putt. 10 to 20 footers, that's the range today. When you're making those, that's when you go low. When you're missing them, you're probably not going low. Dang, just hit it through the break, had the line. Gotta eliminate that from the brain. It was a good roll, it was a good putt. Well played hole. I executed the game plan, I just didn't make the putt. On to the next par five. As weird as it sounds, it could literally be four iron wedge on this next hole. It's a weird play. It's not one that you see very often on a par five, hitting an iron off the tee, but it's just a funky tee shot that always kind of gets in my head. So instead, we just want to take that bunker out of play, give myself a nice layup. Thanks. That's why we hit the four iron. Gonna be a ways back, but four iron, three wood, little chip wedge, hopefully birdie. The game plan on the tee was four iron in either four iron or three wood as a layup. I'm going with the three wood. I like my positioning here. 320 to the pin. This middle bunker is the aiming point. Just trying to carry the middle bunker, leave myself like, I'd say probably 60 yards in. No. As of now, the game plan has not paid off. That is the exact bunker you don't want to be in. Now we're gonna have a 60-yard bunker shot. Actually, not as bad as I thought. I got about 45 yards, maybe. I like this play to hit a 50 degree and kind of still be able to hit behind the ball, because picking this is where it gets a little bit freaky. I mean, I'm still not in a bad spot. All things considered, I've been in way worse positions, especially if you hit it in that fairway bunker off the tee. Typically, you're leaving yourself 150 plus into this hole. I would way rather take this, so I can't really complain. 50 degree in hand, nice and full, just kind of hit an inch behind it or so. Oh. That is just not what you want to see. I got about probably 2 inches behind that ball, not an inch. That's why they call that the hardest shot in golf right there. You have to be so precise. Now I gotta chip that in. I thought I had an easier shot than I do. Kind of have a ridge, and it honestly makes this very challenging, but I don't know. We gotta hope for par at worst on this hole. 58 degree in hand. Very happy with that shot from there. Par five, not what you wanna see here. About 3 footer here. Hey, I will take that up and down 10 times out of 10. Not quite reachable today. The other day when Quan and I played, I was front bunker. I think I can get it Pretty close to that though, maybe 30 yards short of the green. 400 yards, driver in hand here. Just one that you want to kind of smack away at. That's fairway. Wow. I haven't hit a golf shot like that in a minute. It's in the wrong fairway. Dang. This hole and the last hole are the two easiest holes in the course. I just have a tendency of doing this, folks. Can't be shooting good numbers if you're doing this. 122, got a loft of 54 over a tree on a downhill slope out of a bunker. The odds are very stacked against me. That's all right. Anything on the green, I'm gonna be thrilled about, especially if it's within 25 feet. You know, the only thing that really makes sense is an open 50 degree and try and cut it up and over the tree. Garrett, it's just not it. That is just not it. Lots of attackable holes out here, and this is definitely on that list. Gotta focus up. Guess we're having to make birdies the hard way. 30 yards, 58 degree in hand. Just trying to carry the bunker and roll this one up there. That's going right. Hey, if I make another par save, I can't complain after all the trash shots I've been hitting on these first three holes. Oh, that stings, that stings. Not giving the hole away. Aiming right at it, straight up the hill. This would be a huge par. Come on. What kind of golf am I playing right now? This is the dumbest thing ever. I'm even through three. Realistically, I should be not even through three. That's all right. We'll take it. Beautiful weather. Just can't beat it. No one on the course, so we're playing pretty quick. Vibes are high. I'm glad I didn't miss that putt. On to the next. 456, aim at these left bunkers and just kind of work it off of it. Wind's kind of pushing it right, so it shouldn't have a problem moving right. Driver in hand. Get right. Come back in it.
Nope, you're out.
Yes. I'm always in one of those bunkers left because you just have to avoid going right at all costs in this hole, but I got lucky. I got lucky. Perfect lie, perfect shot, perfect drive. Everything was just so perfect. I got so lucky, but I am in a good spot. 196, we're going for the cover number 178, downwind, straight downwind. Gonna hit 8-iron, it should fly on me a good amount. Should be the right club. No, that's not getting there. High, spinny, soft. We'll take it, but I knew it was short. I think my main goal on this putt, just hit my line, give it a roll, give it a nice roll. And as Quan always says, scare the hole. Dying speed is the goal here. Wow, okay, I thought I made that for a second. Rolled it right over my line, nice speed. I will take that par. After everything considered, we're on to a par three. We're still in a good spot with today's round, even par through four. Gotta find something. I will say that. I gotta find something in the swing. And I think I will. I really do. I've been playing pretty decent lately, so just gotta dig deep, find that. We'll be good. 156, kind of a weird shot, I'll say that. Because I'm thinking nine, but I think there's more wind up there than expected. Yeah, I'm gonna go nine, compress nine. Lead the handle, lead the shaft, nice and full. Oh, had to give it everything I had with that 9-iron. Barely got it to the front edge of the green, but now I'm putting up the hill, so I'm happy with that. Left to right for the birdie, take it to 1-under. This would be huge. This would be huge for my round today. Kind of snapping off this ridge on the left side, I think. I've overread two birdie putts in a row that are left to right today. That is on me. Both my birdie looks have been nice today, like the realistic birdie looks, and I just slightly misread them. I'm rolling it well, though. That's a positive. I am rolling it well today. Dogleg left, par four, par five. I'm an idiot. Trying to carry this bunker on the left side a little bit, a little draw hole, that's what it calls for. Driver in hand, let's attack. It is time to attack. We've been slow and steady, but slow and steady does not win the race in these challenges. Carry, 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 carry. Got to, right? Yes. needed that. 205 into the wind. I'm gonna go 5-iron. 4-iron is just a tad too much. I could try and punch a 4-iron and roll it up since I have such a nice little runway here. Feel better about a full 5 here because being short on this hole is not bad with this pin location. Catch, no, not another bunker, Garrett. Perfect distance, is that bunker probably? Small mistakes, that's all right. We can still, I hold out in a bunker 2 days ago, so I can do that. I like this bunker shot, guys, I really do. Straight away, makeable shot, right to left, like a putt. Not bad, just pulled it a bit. Those are fun shots, when you just get up there and you just feel like you're gonna make it. That's why I pulled the pin. It's like a good mental reference. When you're on the green, you pull the pin because you want to make the putt. If you're off the green, it's a very makeable shot. Pull the pin. It's for mentality. That's what it is. Big swinger here. Left to right, down the hill. Just trying to tap it on my line and it should trickle in. That was not the easiest putt. I was breaking maybe like 4 or 5 inches. I'm happy I was able to make that. To 1 under we go. A little penetrated draw here into the wind. Par 4, dogleg left. Good drive, very birdieable hole. Didn't love that ball flight, but I'm not mad about it. A little further than you want, about 140 into this hole. Not bad. It's either full 54, easy 50. I'm trying to decide because this wind is picking up. The easy 50 tends to go left on me. If anything, I'll hit this and it'll be hopefully 5 feet short. Don't mind that at all. Nice, safe play for 10 feet for birdie. Come on, let's go. Little left to right here. Gotta trust it. Feels like it breaks more than it does. Just get it to 2 under. Oh, I tried to under-read a putt and it broke more than expected. So these greens are tricky. If I can start rolling the putts though and start making them, I'll be in a really good spot. On to the next, hold 8. All right, driver in hand, trying to work a draw at these right bunkers. Just trust it. Probably the weirdest driving hole in all of Dallas. It's up there, I will say that. It's dogleg left, very funky, but just gonna trust it. Sit! Catch the bunker, stay in the bunker. Did it carry into the bunker? Thank God. If that carries the bunker, we're in a bad situation. That's what always freaks me out, guys. I can't even lie, because especially right now, I'm hitting a cut. The last thing you want to do is aim over those trees left and unluckily hit one straight. In my opinion, I think this is a par hole. You got to hit driver because it's so long, but it's also one where you kind of aren't mad if you make par. Okay, we're in the bunker. Yes, that is. So one of the first times and last times that I'm going to root for being in a bunker. Now I got to hit a lofty 7-iron, 167. Up the right side, hopefully draw one in there nice. Biggest thing is height on this one. Not a great lie, unfortunately. Had some weird luck out of bunkers recently. Yeah, it's a mental barrier right there. That shot right there, I was really scared of thinning it into the lip, so I'm not actually too upset with it. I don't love to see it, but we can hopefully wedge one close, make par, keep the round at 1 under. With how the swing's been feeling, I will be very happy with that. Favorite yardage, 69 yards. A little into the breeze, off the right. Trying to play a knockdown skipper. Land it just short, skip it up there. Yikes, not good. Gotta make a putt. All right, these are some thick raindrops coming down. They're coming down kind of sporadically, but they're so thick. I said I wasn't gonna do it. I'm not gonna line it up. Just gonna trust my feel here, right to left. First bogey of the day, even par through 8. I've had a couple good par saves, which are nice, and then I've kind of hit a couple shaky shots with the driver, but other than that, I feel like I'm cruising and I feel good about the back 9. As long as this wind kind of stays down, there's a lot of attackable holes, some of which are eagle holes on the back 9. All right, 160, I'm between 8 and 9. 9-iron draw here, that's the goal. sit. That's so long. Wow. Wow. Try to just ride that wind. I think I rode it a little too hard. Up and over a ridge, uphill, then slightly downhill. Very tricky putt here. For me, I'm really thinking about speed on this putt more than anything. Yikes. That was weird. That was really weird. Just felt so slow for some reason. Didn't even give it a chance. Ah, that stings really hard. Two bogeys in a row. I've been cruising today, and unfortunately, just had two bad holes in a row. But that's all right. We're on to the next. I can't be thinking about the pass. We made two bogeys. It is what it is. One over par. On to the next. Par four. I told Ryder I'm dialing it in. Not talking too much. Just going to focus. Driver in hand. Just wanted to avoid that tree. I was behind it yesterday. I'm fine. I don't care if I'm on the right side. I just did not want to be behind that tree. Don't mind this one bit. Little right of the pin. Got a nice bounce. About 8 feet here. Grain and slope both moving left. It's all right. Missed some opportunities today so far. Got to keep riding the horse though. So I guess got to keep going. 200 yards, 7 iron. Got to loft this one, ride the wind, and land it really soft here. Hey. I want you guys to take a look at what we're looking at here. 2 feet long of the pin on your tee shot, and you're 40 feet away. 2 feet left of the pin from here, 40 feet away. It's one that you want to leave it just short right, but even then, like, you lag your putt 2 feet long, 40 feet. I have to go for the bump and run. Just land it short of the green, I guess. Wow. Have to take relief from that. Dang it, guys, this is just brutal. And then that right there is what I'm talking about. Dang. Really nice wedge shot. Now I'm unfortunately 20 feet away for bogey. Yep, 4 iron here. Straight away, par four, a little into the breeze. I mean, it's just the way golf goes. You make some double bogeys every once in a while. I don't like that I'm uploading a video like this where the goal is obviously to shoot very low numbers. And now my only goal is really to get it to under par numbers. So it is okay, we've switched the goal. I've had to do that a couple times so far in this series. So just focus up and see if we can get that goal done. Pure to 4 iron. I probably have another 4 iron in. That's crazy. 165 off the right side. Trying to give myself a nice look. The wind just ate my balls up and it's right down there. Could try and hit it, but it's submerged by a couple inches. This is for the par now. Ah, well, another bogey. We'll see what we can do. See if we can still have a miracle last couple holes and shoot a respectable score. I'm thinking about now, if I was in a tournament, what would I do to regroup? What would I do to get a better mentality? I don't know yet. Laying short of the water, little fade here. Sit, maybe? Sit, sit. Oh no, these fairways are so hard, you just never know. I had no spin on that, and it's gonna roll a country mile. Hopefully we're short of the water up there. I don't wanna jinx myself yet, but whenever I do this, whenever I play bad, I can normally, most of the time, turn it around. I can normally have somewhat of a decent finish to shoot around par, because that's where it's so weird, but like, and I've talked about it a couple times on camera, but golf is, it obviously, as you guys know, it's so mental, but your brain likes to be where it's comfortable. And whenever I get in the red numbers, and whenever I, and I haven't done it yet in the series, but whenever I start blacking out and taking it deep and I'm like 4 or 5 under, my brain's trying to tell me you need to get back to even par, because that's what you're used to. That's what subconsciously my brain likes. Today, I hope it's the opposite, where I'm not playing well and my brain's telling me, all right, get back to where you're comfortable, even par. We'll see. Not the luck that I need right now. Still behind some trees. Hit it a little too far off the tee, 218. Gonna have to hit a hook around it, low 6-iron, roll it up there. It's a doable shot, I'll say that. Landed about 40, 50, 60 yards short, hopefully roll it up on the green. Might have gone in. Hey, we're chipping in for eagle. We're getting it back to 2 over, and we're gonna be all right. Golf's a fun game. I love this court so much. Just long of the green, should call for a little nipper here into the wind. 58 degree in hand, I'm a solid 30 yards long. Now it's getting crazy. It's gusting maybe 30 right now. Not what you want, but up the hill for the birdie, about 15 feet. Let's get it to 3 over. This is a much needed putt here. Right in the heart, Garrett. Can't be doing that right now. You can't be leaving putts short. It's all right, another par. All right, driver in hand, straight away par 4. Gonna give this one a rip. That might go 420 yards. I'm not even joking. That might go over 400 yards. It is, I think it did. I wanna measure this drive. I have an impossible shot now, 77 yards, so just under 400 yards. The only problem is I'm short-sighted, blowing 40 miles an hour. It's safe to say we did not pick the best day to do a break 65. Look at the water, Ryder. Zoom in on that. This is crazy. This is coming out of nowhere. Wow. Okay. I mean, it started off nice. I was trying to break 65 today, and then this happened. This is crazy. Not a great position, actually. I got to loft this one in the air and land it very soft. 58 degree. 77 yards, kind of a tucked pin, so we'll see what we can do. Left to right, a good amount, but the wind's pushing right to left, so I don't really know how to play this. I'm gonna still play for the break, but I think it's gonna break less. Oh my gosh, it's so hard in this wind. The wind pushed it. Oh man. Whew. I think this is maybe the most wind I've played in a long time. I grew up in Kansas City, so I'm kind of used to wind, but this is insane. Got a pitching wedge in hand. A little down off the left. Kevin's in there nice. The wind's just grabbing the ball, so you kind of have to aim it about 25 yards left here. Okay, a little long. We'll take it though. Played for the win. Moved it about 15 yards to the right. I think now the goal is shout out Rick Shields to break 75. Holy crap. This is supposed to be moving right, this putt. But I think it's actually gonna move left. Like watch this, this is crazy. The slope's moving right. I gotta play it right to left. Still did kind of go right. There's a par. We're still 5 over, 3 holes left. It's crazy, 2 days ago I played Kwan and I was 2 under on this side. Today I'm 4 over on this side. I'm gonna try and rip driver here. I'm gonna actually step into this one, hit it hard. Look at that wind just tug my balls. I actually hit that with probably a straight ball flight and I think it moved about 35 yards. I have 30 yards. Just right of the green. This is actually a little bit of advice for you guys at home if you're getting into the game. If you're playing on a windy day and it's a crosswind and you know how to work the ball, ride the wind, especially off the tee if you want to hit it farther. Because what I just did is, even though it wasn't downwind, I used the left to right wind to my advantage. I hit a nice high, took the spin off of it, cut, and it rode it, and it in turn went a lot farther than it would have if I hit a draw into the wind. I have to say, I might have been a little bit scared of the bunker, but that one spun back because of the wind. That's crazy. This is for my birdie, guys. I'm just gonna play it straight. It did try and go left with the wind. It tried to. Another par. Two holes remain. Sometimes it gets to me, it's a little frustrating when I come out here and I try and shoot obviously a very low number and I'm not playing well, but I enjoy playing in the wind a lot. You have to get creative. You have to hit shots that you wouldn't normally have to hit. As of now, I'm having a good time, and I hope you guys are having a good time watching. Yeah, I'm gonna try and ride the wind, kind of like what I just talked about on the last hole. Nice draw, driver in hand. Ride the wind. Yeah, this couldn't be better. The pin's on the left. Yeah, it's gonna look sick.
Oh! Oh! Wait! That go in? Is that in, Ryder? Ryder, is that in? Is it in? Wait, we have to drive it. Keep it rolling, Ryder. Keep it rolling. Are you kidding me? What the? Oh my God. Dude, are you kidding me? 270. I know it's in vertical. It's not filmed for a YouTube video, but one of the craziest shots I just ever hit, ever. Some weird things have happened today. I come out here, I'm trying to shoot 65. The wind gets up to 40 miles an hour. And then I almost hole out from 270 yards with a hybrid. Dude, this day is just weird. Let's go hit my ball and finish this round. I'm 5 over. Got a 50 degree, trying to ride the wind. I can barely hit this ball now after that adrenaline rush, but we're gonna try. That was just absurd, guys. That was absurd. Oh God, wind. Sit, wind, stop. Stop. Definitely needed to aim way more right on that one. I hit it well though. I need redemption after that hole denied me of my balls. Let's make something happen. 58 degree in hand. Kind of pulled it, kind of hit it hard. Dude, I'm so flabbergasted right now. I can't even focus on this round. There have been too many crazy things. Gotta finish strong though. There we go. There's a par. Don't mind that. 5 over. On to the last. If I absolutely smash a drive and smash a 3-wood, I can get it there in 2. I'm gonna try and somehow reach it. I don't know if it's possible. Actually, it's probably not. I mean, we're going into a 30 mile an hour, 25 mile an hour at least wind here, and I'm gonna have to just kill a drive, kill a 3-wood to get it there. That's all I got, and it's still probably, it was low, no spin, and maybe went 250. 130 layup, I got a pitching wedge, just trying to chip one out left. I have 275 into a gale force wind. There's no getting it there. Go! I don't think I hit it hard enough. I might have just left myself a long ways, actually. I could have hit it 90 yards more. I shot it to the trees, and I didn't know there was a lot more room past the trees. Instead, I have 194 into this wind. That is a 4-iron today. Go. Dude, that... Gotta get this up and down to shoot, like I said, 77. Not my day. 58 degree in hand. Nice shot there. Very nice. 2-putt for a 78. Do something for me. Hey, when it's not your day, it's not your day, and that's okay. Well, that wraps it up. Some crazy things happened. Kevin, thanks for having me today.
That's fine, man.
Appreciate it. That hybrid shot, the wind, gusting, it's been an adventurous day, and I'm just thankful that the rain stayed away. That's a 78 on the card. Not what you want, but it's okay.
Guys, I just got back from the course. Disappointed, to say the least, with my performance on the course today. I think a lot of it was to do with course management. My biggest mistake was the double bogey on the par three. I should have known that you absolutely cannot miss left on that pin location. Like, you are literally screwed. And if you do, you have to take your medicine, you have to hit it past the hole, and you gotta try and make a putt. I think that's one thing where I struggle with as a golfer is I gotta know when to step back. And in a situation like that, you don't want to get aggressive and try and hit a bunker run. What I should have done is just hit some sort of a flop shot, maybe out to the right, and maybe two putt or make a long putt for par, and just take the bogey and walk away. Next hole was just an error. I had the right club, I just pulled it. I drew it too much into that wind, so that was my other mistake, hitting in the water. I still made a bogey, which all things considered is not awful. So I'd say those were my two big mistake holes. I think I've said this a lot, but I need to improve on a couple things, specifically putting from 10 to 20 feet. I've been saying that, and I've been saying that to myself. That's where I struggle the most, is 10 to 20 feet. Anywhere in that range, I need to be making those putts if I want to shoot any scores under par, in the 60s, and especially if I want to break 65 at one point. For those of you that don't know, my record is still 67. Obviously, my best score in the Break 65 series so far has been a 72. Lots of positives though leading into the next episode. I'm not 100% sure where we're going to be filming it, but one thing that I do know is I'm a better golfer now than I was when I shot 67. It is doable, and it's out there. Even if it takes 2 to 3 years of me doing this series, I will not stop until eventually I shoot that 64 number. I can't wait till I'm coming down to the wire on the last hole and I'm 6 under, right at the number 7 under or something, and I have to make a putt or something like that. Like, eventually I know that will happen. And I hope you guys still enjoyed that video, even though I shot a freaking 78, 6 over par, and it wasn't great. I had a lot of fun today on the course. Once the wind picked up, I actually enjoyed it even more. I don't know why, playing in the wind just is, it's so fun to me, because you have to be so creative and think of new shots. Hit low, high, draw, fade, and all that. And I enjoy that side of golf. Let's give it a review. Let's rate all my parts of my game, 1 through 10. Putt it. It was a 3 today, if I'm being honest. If that, we'll say 2.7. We'll meet somewhere in the middle. Wedges, pretty solid. I gave myself good looks when I had a wedge in the hands. Anywhere from 120 to 85 if I was in the fairway. I was putting it pretty close and I just couldn't make the putt. So wedges, 9, make it 9. Shorts and mid irons were okay. I would say like a 6.2. Long irons, I really didn't have many long irons for the most part. Whenever I hit them, it was off the tee and I hit them well. So, I mean, I had one on bull 18, but that was into a 35 mile an hour wind gust, so 8.7, pretty solid. Driver was okay, not great, definitely could have improved, and we'll go 6.9. that includes like driver, hybrid, three wood, so I'd say that, yeah, right around 6.9 for that. Overall, not great, could have been worse, but sure as hell needs to be better if I want to shoot a 65 or even under par. So stay tuned for the next episode, guys. A lot of fireworks in today's video. Actually, just one specific big firework. The almost sold out 270 yard hybrid was an added bonus to today, and that's what I love so much about golf. You can have a really terrible round like I did, and hit one good shot, and it just keeps you coming back for more, no matter what. And that hybrid is what's going to keep me coming back. I hope you guys enjoyed. Yeah, good, bad, ugly, whatever. I'm going to still upload it. So, till next time, guys. Peace.